So what are some of your favorite memories off the track that you had?
Wow.
Is this a PG-13 show?
Hi, I'm Eric Stewart. Everybody calls me Stu. I've been Stu for, as long as I can remember. All through high school and stuff. So the nickname stuck. Followed me into auto racing. A little town in northwestern Connecticut called Canaan. Right next door to Lime Rock. So, sort of grew up with racing in the blood. We had a fine road course right there in our backyard. I'm a transportation driver. I drive Hinch's truck. I'm going to take care of the pit setup, maintenance of all the wheel guns, air jack wands for both cars. And when we're at the shop, I just plumb the car. So all the fuel lines, brake lines, air jack lines, and anything plumbed on the car.
So it sounds like you do a lot.
So, kind of like, jack of all trades, master of none. Well, I've been doing this for a lot of years. And pretty much know everybody out here. Got a lot of storied history out here. One of some really great drivers. Got two championships back in the kart days. One with Michael Andretti in 91. One with Nigel Mansell in 93. This will be my 31st Indy 500. I finally got one win in 13 with Tony Kanaan.
Wow.
I was working for KV Racing. Really been a lifelong dream to finally achieve that. It was a pretty happy moment.
So when you won Indy in 2013, how long had you been in business?
So 2013, so we're going back 5 years, would have been 26 years. Been close a couple times. Won the Indy 495 a whole bunch of times. I was at Newman Haas for 12 years, and prior to that I actually worked at the Smith Barber Racing, based out of the Lime Rock area. And transitioned and made friends on the Newman Haas crew and had an opening for a parts guy and slid right in. The thing about Newman Haas, if you work there, no matter when you work there, you're all a teammate. Everybody is very family oriented cat when you're there, and a lot of great drivers, a lot of great mechanics. Out of there, and like, unfortunately, you see a lot of them here in Paddock. You know, we all have that Newman Haas. 99 was my last year at Newman Haas, and I ended up actually working for a couple of parts companies, supply companies. We took care of everything from sprint cars, drag racing, all forms of professional motorsports. Worked for a manufacturer for 10 years, CNR Racing, did a lot of NASCAR. We also did a lot of IndyCar work. That being said, I was able to still do pit stops and work the teams, you know, one-off during the month of May. So it was always great to get back to the 500. And I've had some great shots with guys like A.J. Foyt and Gary Bettenhausen, Rob Gordon. Worked for a bunch of guys at Speedway doing one-off. You know, it's there's been a lot. It's, you know what, most of it just the traveling with the guys that I've got to run with in the trucks and the transporters. We've gone coast to coast, walked a lot of miles, made a lot of great friends. We've always tried to make the trips as entertaining as possible. Unfortunately, when I committed in 85 with Skip Barber, I didn't realize this was a life sentence without chance of parole. So I've done this for so long, very comfortable. Still enjoy competitive aspect of racing, and work with some great people. I can continue doing this as long as I can do this. It's not really anything I'd rather do. I mean, look at our office here. It doesn't get much better.
It gets much better when you're working,
Stu. You know, it's a, I don't know. I guess we're kind of broken, maybe. they need to have a wing at the Betty Ford Center for a motorsports addiction. Everybody out here, you know, it takes a special breed to do this, to be away from family, be away from friends, be away from home. And it is a lot of hours. It's a lot of miles, a lot of trucks. But we all have that competitive fire. It's so much fun to get out here and just try and beat your hands off of some of your best buddies. And
and still be able to go up to dinner, you know, and yuck it up and laugh and have a good time. I mean, there's
quite a few guys on various groups here during the month of May. We're all on motorcycles and get to go out riding with a lot of really good groups. It's like a big happy dysfunctional family out here.
Yeah.